Now on to the differences between Swift and Objective-C. Let's start with how they handle nil. As you know, Swift treats nil values with a great deal of care, wrapping anything that could have a nil value in an optional type. Objective-C is much less concerned with nil values. The language doesn't need the concept of an optional because any object can have a nil value, no problem. Surprisingly, in Objective-C, you can invoke a method on a nil pointer with relatively little consequence. Watch. Here's some code that represents a bike messenger picking up a package. Here I'm initializing a messenger, and then he picks up a package. Now let's press run, and since we've got a log statement here, we can look down here in the console and see package contents, top secret stuff. Now watch what happens if I set the value of the bike messenger spike to nil. First of all, the compiler doesn't care. If this were Swift, the code wouldn't even compile. And then when I run the code, it handles it like it was nothing. Down here in the console, we see package contents, null. But there's no crash, there's no null pointer exception like we'd get in Java. Now in this toy example, the fact that nothing happens when we invoke a method on spike isn't such a big deal. But in general, you don't want your program doing nothing when it's supposed to be doing something. You may find yourself frequently checking for nil values, even though they won't crash your program per se. Objective-C's relaxed attitude toward nil values also has some implications for debugging, which we'll talk about more in the lesson on interoperability between Swift and Objective-C.